Hello guys, for today we are going to talk about partial fraction expansion related to our PICD. Okay, first of all, we have been tasked to find the inverse of Laplace transform by using the repeated roots formula. Okay, first of all, the things that we need to know about Laplace transform is it has a general form, which is this equation. So, our task is that we have chosen the questions from the lecturers, which is this equation, Ys equal to 3s plus 1 over s plus 2 times s plus 1 to the power of 3. So next, to explain about the using of the general form, I will pass to my friend Priyanka.
Hi everyone, my name is Priyanka. So I'm going to carry on where my teammate has left off. So we know the equation that we have in hand, and we've also learned the general form. So I hope everyone is aware of how we're going to proceed with this. So to be sure, we have our denominator, and now we want to split it up into segments. So first we take s plus 2, we make that into our first component and we give it a as its denominator, I mean its numerator, sorry. And then we take s plus 1 to the power of 3, which means this term has to be divided into 3 consecutive parts. So we have s plus 1 to the power of 2, and s plus 1 to the power of 3. And each of that we give a numerator of b, c and d. The coefficient is completely up to you. You can make it c1, you can make it p, you can make it q, whatever it is that you want, as long as it can be determined separately. After which now, we want to make all of these terms similar. So what's the best way that we can do this? Make the denominators the same. So as you can see, what we have done is taken the similar denominators and we times it with the coefficients. So we have fa, s plus 1 to the power of 3, because we've cancelled out the s plus 2 in the whole denominator. And we do the same with b, c and d. Once we have the same denominator for everything, you can actually cancel it off with the original equation, which comes back to 3s plus 1 over all the numerators that we have collected before after this. So now I will proceed to pass on to my teammate to continue the session.
Shazani. Now I will proceed to the part of solving the constant, the four of the constant. I will use the method of equalization between the 3s plus 1 and the constant at the right hand side. So from the coefficient of S3, we'll get A plus B is equal to 0, because the coefficient of S3 at the right side is equal to 0, there is no S cubed. Then from the coefficient of S2, 3A plus 4B plus B is equal to 0 as well, as same as the S cubed. And from the coefficient of S, 3A plus 5B plus 3C plus D is equal to 3, because at the right side, S from the coefficient of S is equal to 3. So now I'll proceed to my next teammate to further explain about the solving of the four constants.
I'm combined. So continuing on the question, we need to find the value of A, B, C and D. So we refer back to the equation of the general form. So to find A, we need to look at the denominator of A, which is S plus 2. So we assume S equal to negative 2. Then we solve this and we will get A equal to 5. The same with D. We must look at the denominator of D, and then we assume S equal to negative 1. And then we solve it, we will get D equal to negative 2. And for C, we need to look at the equation from the coefficient of S power of 2, which is 3a plus 4b plus c equal to 0. So we will get c equal to a. So c equal to 5. And next, b. We will refer to the coefficient of s equal s power of 3. So we get b equal to negative of a. And we get b equal to negative 5. And I pass to my friend to continue with the question.
Hi, I'm Amy, and I will proceed from what from where my teammate stopped. So, as we know the coefficient of A, B, and C, C and D, so we plug into the first equation we construct, we get this equation 5 over S plus 2 minus 5, and so on. So, this, as we know, Ys is the Laplace transform, the Laplace form. So, what from we want in the first question, we want to the inverse Laplace transform. So we transform it into t, this. Why is turned into this? I explain from one term to one term. Okay, the first term, 5 over s plus 2. From the we know the general equation for the Laplace. The 1 over s minus 2 minus a. So from this, we know that a negative the plus 2 is negative a. So a we know that is negative 2. So the 5 is the constant. 5 times e power of negative 2t. So for the second term is similar to the first term. So the third term and the fourth term is quite difficult, and I will explain by writing it. So the third term we have 5 over s plus 1 power of 2. From this general Laplace formula, we know that the n plus 1, the power of 2 is n plus 1, so n equals to 1. So this terms of n, we know that it becomes 5 times 1 factorial over s minus s plus 1 power of 1 plus 1. So we transfer it into this. It's 5 times t power of 1 e power of negative 1 t. 1t. Then this is the third term. For the fourth term, we get negative 2 over s plus 1 power of 3. Then we know that n equals to 2 power of 2. So this term, n factorial, is equals to the negative sign in left outside. It's 2 factorial over s plus 1 power of 2 plus 1. Then we turn it to the inverse Laplace. Negative t power of 2 e power of negative 1 t. That's it. That's what we get. So that's all from our group, the group of 8. And then that's it. Thank you.